Let's make homemade ricotta to learn the basics of the science behind cheese. First, you're going to need milk, heavy cream, and salt, and you can add that to a medium pot on the stovetop or a large microwave-safe bowl or even a mason jar. We've done them all and they all work. Heat the milk to 180 to 190 degrees Fahrenheit, which takes about 5-ish minutes. If doing it in the microwave, be careful because the glass or whatever you're heating it in will also get hot, so make sure you're using gloves. And then check it every minute so that way you can make sure it's cooking evenly and not overheating. Next, add in your lemon juice and stir just gently to make sure the lemon juice is evenly distributed. Then let it sit for 5 minutes. During this time, you're going to see the very beginnings of the chemical reaction and the beginnings of that cheese in these curds that look, okay, maybe now you're questioning why you're making this ricotta and cheese in general and wondering if it's really gonna be as delicious as you thought it was, but trust us, it is. Over time, it's going to transform, and this is the same exact way that mozzarella, cheddar, parmesan, any cheese is formed. It all starts with curds. Next, strain out and separate the curds from the rest of the liquid. Now, normally you'd use a cheesecloth, but we didn't have one and figure a lot of people don't, so we decided to try out different methods to see if there was another way to separate out the curds. We first tried a strainer, which didn't work at all because it's just not fine enough, but then we used a paper towel, which worked out great. If you're using a mason jar, you can actually just use a paper towel and secure it with a rubber band. Let the curds sit and drain, and this is where you can play around with time. The longer you let the curds sit, the thicker it will be and the more liquid that will strain out. Generally, 1 to 2 hours is best. This is after 2 hours and 15 minutes. From here, you can use the ricotta however you want. Our favorite way was to spread it onto a lightly toasted baguette, top with some freshly diced tomatoes, a drizzle of balsamic glaze, salt, and pepper. Making ricotta or any cheese is all about the curds, which form when specific proteins found in milk go through a chemical reaction. Now, milk is actually made up of two proteins, casein and whey, but this is all about the casein proteins. When we heat up the milk and then add an acid like lemon juice, it causes the casein proteins to chemically change, and we see this as they visibly separate into curds. Now, casein proteins are pretty complex, but basically they have a negative charge on the outside of them, which causes them to repel one another as we see in milk. But to create a curd, we need them to come together and clump. And so to do that, we need to neutralize that negative charge so they aren't repelling one another. And that's where heat and an acid do the trick. Acids have a proton or hydrogen ions, which essentially bind to the casein protein, neutralizing out that negative charge and allowing the casein proteins to now come together in this solid curd. Once the casein proteins have formed that solid curd, we can physically separate them out through straining. The longer we strain the curds, the more the water drains from them, and we can visibly see that, especially if we do this in a mason jar. To learn a little bit more detail about how this all works, check out our Science Behind Mozzarella video. To tinker with this, you can play around with the amount of time you drain the curds, try out different acids in place of lemon juice like vinegar or citric acid, or try out different ratios of heavy cream to whole milk, which we did and thought that more heavy cream would result in a richer product, but it actually just made it really hard to strain out. You could also try out different milks, but keep in mind those casein proteins, which are found in dairy-based milks, are key to curds. So it may not work out, but still definitely worth trying, just setting expectations. Let us know if you try this activity. We hope you had fun, and be sure to like and subscribe for more videos.